For the findings of the study, the findings are divided into three main sections, namely the influencers from the early childhood, the experiences of perpetration, and the experiences of the interventions received. For the influencers from early childhood, the study revealed that the violent experiences of this individual during childhood have influenced their behavior and have been a factor to their propensity to violence. But in the family, they have experienced harsh parental discipline, which includes the act of physical punishments, harsh verbal discipline, and as well as the neglection. Also, they have been exposed to abusive head of the families where they witness their parents in an abusive cycle. Also, within the school setting, they have experienced corporal punishments and assaults from their teachers. Also, according to the intergenerational transmission of family violence, those people who have experienced violence within their family as they grew up have a greater tendency or possibility to also live in a domestic violence situation. Also, for the second section, experiences of the perpetration, we look into three aspects. Prior to commission, they have been triggered by their partners. Throwing insults, act of disobedience, and heated conversations are what usually occurred before or preceding the perpetration, which end up with violence. Upon the commission, doers of violence lose their self-control and also drown in wrath and anger as they commit the violent act. And after the commission, they felt the deep remorse and guilt, and as well as begin rationalizing the violent act. Also noted in the study are the partaking changes that is happening within the family relationship of the doers of violence. Specifically, their partners have become cold to them or indifferent, and their children is unfortunately has grown distant to them. Lastly, for the experiences of the perpetration, for the interventions received, there are three aspects that we look into: the effectivity, the satisfaction, and the equality of the services. In terms of the services for awareness of the bossy and those inclusive interventions where men are heard and favored have helped the doers of violence reform and change. However, there are others who state that the services were not effective. In terms of the fairness and equality, men have misconceptions that all the centers and interventions available are just for women and that they are just biased towards men. And for the satisfaction, they are somehow satisfied but still recommended on catering men in the intervention. So for the respondents' recommendation, it revolves around two aspects. First is the creation of services and interventions that are inclusive to men and that use a holistic approach in its intervention. And lastly, they emphasize on the importance and vitality of educating the doers of violence on the issue of bossing. And now, based on the findings of this study, the following are the recommendations. We have included promotion of helpful intervention and programs for the men, especially for the doers of violence. Future study regarding the services provided for the people who committed domestic violence should be conducted. Formulation of effective treatment for doers of violence. Also, we have a strengthened barangay programs to address both women and the doers of violence should be implemented. Strengthening and giving more emphasis about domestic violence and its implications during marriage counselings. Domestic violence prevention education program must further be given emphasis as lack of knowledge and ignorance of domestic violence appears to be prevalent.
So as we have conducted this research study, we have realized that in addressing the issue of the doers of violence, we are also addressing the issue of gender-based violence and domestic violence as a whole. So thank you so much, Dr. Sansa.